My name is Andrea Alu. I work at the University of Texas at Austin, Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. I work in the area of metamaterials. My background is in electromagnetic theory, and now we do theory and experiments in electromagnetics spanning from RF to optics and in acoustics, working on these artificial materials that have unusual interactions with waves. So we try to boost the interactions between waves and matter at small scales to build new devices, new concepts for goes from material science to applied technology. The topic is quite general, and being a theorist by background helps, because sometimes we develop concepts in optics, but then we run experiments in radio frequencies or acoustics, if it makes it easier to demonstrate some concepts on larger scales. We have also several collaborations with faculty in my department or my school or all over the world, both in US and in Europe. What my specific group has been working on is trying to push the challenges and limitations of today's metasurfaces to new directions by engaging different fields together into the metasurface platform. For instance, we have shown that you can get very large concentrated nonlinear responses at deeply sub-wavelength scales. You can use then the metasurface concepts to tailor these nonlinearities. We have shown that you can use metasurfaces with active or time-varying or large nonlinear responses to challenge some of the symmetries that are inherently limiting how metasurfaces should respond, like time reversal symmetry and reciprocity, or geometrical symmetries that limit the efficiency of surfaces, or that have some requirements on the type of magnetic responses, a magnetoelectric coupling on a surface. So in general, we are trying to enrich the metasurface platform with new concepts like hybrid surfaces, multiphysics, optomechanical interactions, anything that can leverage more than 1 degree of freedom, not just electromagnetic engineering, can open interesting directions for this kind of metasurface technology. One of the specific, to go more into details, specific applications that we've been looking at are surfaces that allow you to break the symmetry with which waves propagate, for instance, creating essentially thin surfaces that reflect only from one side, so transmit from one side but don't allow transmission from the opposite side. So break reciprocity, create isolation based either on time-varying elements that form the surface, or large nonlinearities that allow you to break this symmetry in that fundamentally is dictated by time reversal, by the fact that waves propagate equally when you reverse time. Using nonlinearities or time variations on the surface, you can actually break these inherent symmetries. And another direction that we've been quite interested in pursuing is the idea of using active elements in these surfaces. So by providing energy to the basic elements forming the surface, or gain, you can actually break some of the fundamental challenges of passive surfaces. So you can make, you can compensate loss, you can realize effects that go, that are more broadband than what, than the conventional bounds that passive surfaces have to comply with. And you can generate even very intriguing effects, like in the area of parity time symmetry or parity time symmetric metasurfaces, surfaces that have a balanced distribution of loss and gain, and can generate very unusual effects that would not be available in passive materials. Following similar directions, we also showed that you can realize electromagnetic cloaks that can challenge the inherent bounds on bandwidth that are associated with passive materials. So you can get broadband, low scattering objects using balanced distributions of gain and loss around an object. So this is one direction, but then we have also worked fundamentally on this idea of patterning surfaces with time-varying elements. And this, we have used this in many many topologies to realize one-way propagation on the surface or in free space, and essentially create new ways of tailoring or transporting signals, both in terms of theoretical challenges, understanding really these platforms, and in realizations and the possible devices that can be realized with these concepts, is the idea of combining actually different physics platforms into the same surface. So taking advantage of strong coupling between different wave phenomena, like acoustoelectric effects or optomechanical effects. Every time you are able to combine two wave phenomena into the same material, hopefully even in deeply sub-wavelength scales, you are able to actually leverage these 2 degrees of freedom, and strongly coupling them get beyond some of the limitations that each of the two subfields has. We've been very interested recently in looking into how to translate these general concepts of active materials or time-varying materials into structures that actually can leverage from other wave phenomena to automatically imprint large, for instance, large modulation patterns on a surface based on propagation of other type of signals. And this is something that I think is very rich and has a lot of interesting questions still open, and very interesting potentials.